You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Wednesday, the 28th of September, 2022, 26th week in ordinary time, and participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Anne Mwaba from Lusaka, Zambia, celebrating her 22nd birthday tomorrow, takes for us the first reading. Rahab Mumbi Wamai from Makuyu, Kenya, celebrating her birthday today, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Joel Mukuka Kapilikisha, a newly ordained Capuchin missionary working in Solwezi, Zambia. Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those listening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Next reading. How can a man be just before God? A reading from the book of Job, Job 9 verse 1 to 12, 14 to 16. Job answered his friends, "Truly, I know it is so, but how can a man be just before God? If one wished to contend with him, one could not answer him once in 1,000 times. He is wise in heart and mighty in strength. Who has hardened himself against him and succeeded? He who removes mountains, and they know it not. When he overturns in his anger, who shakes the earth out of its place, and its pillars tremble? Who commands the sun, and it does not rise? Who seals up the stars? Who alone stretched out the heavens and trembled the waves of the sea? Who made the Bear and Orion, the Pleiades and the Chambers of the South? Who does great things beyond understanding, and marvelous things without number? Behold, he passes by me, and I see him not. He moves on, but do not perceive him. Behold, he snatches away. Who can hinder him? Who will say to him, 'What are you doing?' How can I answer him, choosing my words with him? Though I am innocent, I cannot answer him. I must appeal for mercy to my accuser. If I summoned him and he answered me, I would not believe that he was listening to my voice." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm chapter 88, verse 10 BC to 11, 12 to 13, 14 to 15. Response is taken from Psalm chapter 88, verse 3a. And the response is, "Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord."
Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord.
I call to you, Lord, all day long. To you I stretch out my hands. Will you work your wonders for the dead? Will the shades rise up to praise you?
Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord.
Will your mercy be told in the grave, or your faithfulness in the place of perdition? Will your wonders be known in the dark, your justice in the land of oblivion?
Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord.
But I, O Lord, cry out to you. In the morning my prayer comes before you. Why do you reject me, O Lord? Why do you hide your face from me?
Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
We shall read from Luke chapter 9, verse 57 to 62. At that time, as Jesus and his disciples were going along the road, a man said to him, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus said to him, Foxes have holes, and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. To another he said, Follow me. But he said, Lord, let me first go and bury my father. But he said to him, Leave the dead to bury their own dead. But as for you, go and proclaim the kingdom of God. Another said, I will follow you, Lord. But let me first say farewell to those at my home. Jesus said to him, No one who puts his hand on the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are moving forward with the book of Job, and today Job responds to God. It is like his friends have come to him to actually defend the justice of God, especially his friend Bildad, who defended God's justice. He tells Job, you have been uttering a lot of things, but how long are you going to do this? Can you contend with God? That's the question we are asking here. Are you able to contend with God? Can you really question him over the things that he is doing in your life? Will you accept his answers? Listen, God's ways are not our ways. There is no way we can really challenge what God is doing in our lives. Because when we challenge him, we seem to be telling him, you know what, God, I can do better than you. You know what, God? I think your plans are not what I thought they should be. Job had to learn that in the process of suffering. It is something that came later. You know, suffering is a school. And in that school, there are assignments. And one of the assignments can be a cancerous situation. One of the assignments can be the financial constraint. One of the assignments can be that trouble in your marriage. Another assignment can be the confusion you have at your workplace. Those are assignments. Take them. And you will only pass those assignments when you understand that God has a plan even in what you are going through. Job is in class and he is learning something. He understands that he cannot contend with God. Truly, I know that it is so. But how can a man be in the right before God? Because God is wise in heart and mighty in strength. Who has hardened himself against him and succeeded? No one. No matter how much you may question why God is doing something, you will never find answers here on earth. You will just see it later. Maybe while you are still alive, God may reveal something to you to let you understand why you were going through that. But just know that he is the marker of the exam, and he will show you later if you have passed with a distinction or you still have to continue redoing your exam. That is what we have to know. That much we must learn in our lives as we continue doing his will. He wants us to understand that everything we go through is for a purpose. The gospel passage of today is in the context of the journey towards Jerusalem. Jesus is moving towards Jerusalem, and on the way he meets people who would want to follow him. I will follow you wherever you go. And this is somebody. In Matthew, it is the scribe who says, I will follow you. But here, it is just someone. And Jesus says, you know what? You are not coming for comfort here. You are coming for an examination. You are coming for assignments. And you have to know there will be suffering. There will be assignments in various fields. You're not coming to relax. Be ready for that. To another, he says, follow me. He invites him. But this man says, oh Lord, let me first go and bury my father. You know what? You have to understand how urgent is following me. Don't go back home to go and deal with customs and traditions. Forget about them. Those are dead stuff. Let the dead bury their own dead. You follow me. Follow Christ. Forget about those customs and traditions. Let Christ be the source of your strength and energy. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Wednesday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my day. Your bed.